the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
First down. That's caught by Water out left side. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. 13 yards on the game's opening play.
And the Raider
throwing on first down is Carr. A short one here secured by the tight end Waller. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
The 47-yard line.
And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
The ball carrier. The tackle made just shy of midfield. 2 yards on the play.
Carr now on first down.
Las Vegas.
A short one here secured by the tight end Waller.
Carr's pass.
7 yards to pick up on the pitch and catch. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3.
The Packers 45-yard line.
And his throw's going to be incomplete. Darren Waller, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd and short. By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last 4 or 5 plays, I'm eking over in your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, we're not talking about our on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual for you.
My bad.
Normally, you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play. Going to get this down near the 30-yard line. They get the first. The decision to run on 3rd and medium winds up being a good one. They run it with Jacobs. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
Darnell Savage on the tackle. 4 yards on the pickup.
Carr going to give it to Jacobs. And he'll be dropped at the 23 after a pickup of about 4. And this will be play number 8 of the opening drive. It's 3rd and short. Trying to run for it with Jacobs. And he will be very close to a 1st down, but I see the closed fist of the referee. And that means 4th down.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. Carr to throw for it on 4th down. Able to find Waller. That's complete. And he will have the 1st down before he's tackled at the 12. Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on 4th. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. His pass caught at the 4.
Complete.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the 1st down completion.
On the pickup. Brings up 2nd and 2.
On 2nd down now. Richard. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders.
Touchdown.
A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders drive right down the field and score on the opening drive.
Daniel Carlson.
That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts a defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away, is Carlson. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
The Packers take over 1st and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up 1st and 10 at their own 17-yard line. They'll run it for the first time with Williams. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
On 2nd and 12, Rodgers. That's caught. It's Robert Tonyan, the tight end. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit, and that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Got a man. It's Tonyan complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down.
6 more yards.
A good pick up there, 26 yards. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
End of the first quarter with the score Raiders 7, Packers nothing.
Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run.
2nd and 9.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. And he fires one incomplete.
He's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down. Now, if you're going to get rid of it, you better get outside the pocket.
Yeah, you have to get outside of that tackle-to-tackle box, right? Get out there, and then you can do it legally, but he wasn't able to do so, and they end up losing the down as well.
On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. Oh, it's a wobbler here. And this one will wind up being down just outside of that 20-yard line.
22-yard line.
Carr and the Raiders come up 1st and 10 at their own 22. And he'll throw right away. And that's caught. It's Bryan Edwards. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Gain of 8. Brings up 2nd and 2.
To throw again on 2nd down. Carr, reception here by Ruggs. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Carr gives to Richard. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Ball carrier. Tackle made at the 38-yard line. A 6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4.
Working from the gun, it's Carr. Catch is made by Hunter Renfro. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
First down, Raiders.
Shotgun now for Carr. And his throw is incomplete. Hunter Renfro is a man he was looking for. And it's 2nd down. Just his 2nd incompletion so far. He's 8 for 10. I think he'll take 80%.
There's no doubt that he will, but if you're the defensive play caller, you better circle what you just dialed up on your play sheet and come back to it, because you just caused an incompletion. You need a few more of those.
Carr again here on 2nd and 10. And he comes back with one complete. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1. Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his 3rd and 1. Jacobs now. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Give him a yard on the play, and he's definitely short. It'll be 4th down and a few inches. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. He's got a man open. It's Hunter Renfrow. And able to get this down inside the 15 to either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. A solid pickup of five and a very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play. And he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And the stop will come inside the five at the four. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. It's a three-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal. And they'll turn to the power game to try to get in. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage.
It's not much as perfect in football, but that's about as close to it as you're going to get. Score, force a punt, score again.
And both drives were impressive. The opening drive was, that last one was. Now on the other side, though, what's your psyche? You're really behind the eight ball.
You got to make sure you just hold in there. Survive the early storm. Relax a little bit and try and get back to your game plan. It's way too early for panic.
Their own 25-yard line.
About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team. Right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Green Bay Packer. First and 10 at the 38-yard line.
Looking to throw on second down. Rodgers, that'll be complete to Alan Lazard. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers looking deep for Adams. Got a man. It's caught at the 6-yard line. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Devontae Adams. As the first half is winding down. And the Packers have cut it back within a score. And he knocks it through.
Makes the score Raiders 14. Seven.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper.
And trying to get it to Ruggs, but it's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
The Packers take over first and 10 at their own 49-yard line.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 49. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Final shot before half for Rodgers.
Into
a double team and it's intercepted.
Picked off by Jeff Heath. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gaudin getting set for quarter number three here. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action, ready for the third quarter. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
First and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action.
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five. Shotgun now for Rodgers. This one complete to Tanyan underneath. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 14 yards, good for a Packer first down.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And it'll bring up a second and 13. Working from the gun, Rodgers. And this is caught. Mercedes Lewis with a grab.
Rodgers pass.
And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
To throw, it's Rodgers. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
Really? Really? Did we just see that? That's a big catch. One-handed, I might add, to pick up a first down.
I was going to say, on third down for the defense, it's one thing to give up a reception. You just got to shake your head on a one-handed catch to pick up the first. Now a first down carry, it's Williams. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
No doubt about it, a really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Rodgers' throw is taken in by Jones. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. And that's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10.
3 more yards.
23 yards, the final tally.
First down. First and 10 at the 11-yard line.
Rodgers toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Intended for Aaron Jones. Incomplete.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. On second down, it's Jones. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and 9 looming.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball in this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
They're 2 for 2 on third down conversions on this drive. This one tough. They need 9 yards on third down. Operating from the gun, Rodgers. Touchdown, Packers. Robert Tonyan there to make the grab. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And it was a tight window. He knew he had to rocket that thing in there. He got it done.
And when you're able to complete one like that, your confidence has to just go sky high. You just mentioned it. Tight window, zings it in there despite excellent coverage. Result, touchdown.
Mason Crosby to kick off for Green Bay.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way to run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33. Once again, it's Jacobs. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing, in a situation when they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously, but at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
A short one here, secured by the tight end, Waller. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
From the 39-yard line, here comes 2nd down at 6. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. He's still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to 3rd down. And he's got the 1st down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get him behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. They'll run on first down. Richard. And he's going to get this one down to the 45.
Jalen Richard, the ball.
Brought down that time by Christian Kirksey. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
Fourth quarter, 2 minutes on the clock in a tight one-point game.
That's what I'm talking about. Nice hit, boy.
So it's Raider football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. From the 45 on second down, Carr. He's going to find and complete it to Renfro. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Raiders.
Scrimmage and he goes down right there.
Brought down.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Brings up second and 10 at the 37-yard line.
This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. Now Carr. And he's got the hook up to Ruggs. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. That one goes for 36 yards.
This is what made the West Coast offense a staple around the NFL in the 80s and 90s. You don't have to push the ball deep downfield to come up with big plays, and there's an example of that right there.
They'll run it with Jacobs, and this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
And as this drive began, the offense had to be thinking touchdown, knowing the situation. Even after that loss, touchdown still on their minds. This is a one-possession game. A field goal doesn't do them a whole lot of good.
The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. Through a couple of plays, this Green Bay defense is held strong. Now it's third and goal. They'll run with Jacobs. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
Well, that was absolutely ideal for them, wasn't it? Trying to salt this game away. I think one of my kids just graduated in about the time they had the football. That was absolutely impressive.
Everybody wants those salt away the game drives. What makes them successful?
Well, when you're able to mix run pass, when you're able to control the football and stay ahead of the chains, I'm using every cliche I know, but that's how you get it done, because you're not taking negative plays, and that way you're able to run what you want to run when you get a chance to call it.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
Their own 25-yard line.
About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again, but they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly, then they'll take it from there.
He's going to let it fly. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Devontae Adams, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. On play action, now Rodgers. And this one hauled in by Tavon Austin. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
It's a nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked by Nick Kwiatkowski. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here, down two scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
Now after the INT, it's Carr. A short one here, secured by the tight end, Waller. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. It's a gain of 14 there, and that should be enough to get him home free. Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add three more, a little insult to injury here late in the game. From the left hash mark, this a 43-yard attempt. So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it still ate up time, got points, so while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
And it'll come out to the 25.
Game on.